A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 7th Jan, on the front page you have path chosen by you can lead to anarchy. PM cautions opposition. He says country can't function when a duly enacted law is not obeyed. So this is regarding Citizenship Amendment Act. But so you can see there are state legislatures also which have passed resolutions that they do not accept Citizenship Amendment Act. Then here you have the latest one being Rajasthan, we know in this list. Then here you have rates to fall despite RBI status quo. So the Monetary Policy Committee of RBI had its meeting and it decided to keep the interest rate unchanged in the wake of rising inflation. But it emphasized that there would be space for rate reduction. It will reduce rates later. So here is the repo rate you can see, which has presently remained unchanged for last few quarters, you can see. And this is the lending rate on fresh loans by commercial banks. So the way repo rate comes down, simultaneously lending rate should also come down in the same manner, because repo rate is the interest rate as such, you can say, for banks. So lending rate is the banks which interest rate which banks take from customers, from people. So that is the. So here you can see repo rate is defined. It is rate at which RBI lends money to commercial banks. Here you can see repo rate has been kept unchanged at 5.15%. Then this is Senate acquits President Donald Trump. So the impeachment process as such in USA against President Trump. The House of Representatives, lower house, is has Democrats in majority. They passed the resolution on impeachment, but when it went to Senate, the upper house, where the Republicans are in majority, so Trump, he belongs to Republicans, so he could not be impeached, which was known. So here is the case. Then below you have Omar Mehbooba booked under Public Safety Act. So we had seen Farooq Abdullah, his detention was extended by 3 months. So now again, you know, stringent provisions under Public Safety Act have been slapped against former chief ministers Mehbooba Mufti and Umar Abdullah, and their detention has been extended by 3 months. And this is EC notice, means Election Commission's notice, to Adityanath, Sanjay Singh for model code violation. So both leaders have been asked to respond to allegations by the Election Commission. So UP Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath had said that BJP did not have the habit of serving biryani to terrorists as the Congress was doing in Kashmir and Aam Aadmi Party in Shaheen Bagh. So on this, complaint has been filed and he has to respond to Election Commission for violation of the Model Code of Conduct. On page 9 you have India, African countries resolve to fight terror. So this is several African countries in India who pledged to deepen cooperation to combat the growing threat of terrorism and preserve maritime security by sharing information, intelligence and surveillance. So this was a joint declaration, Lucknow Declaration, adopted at the first India-Africa Defense Ministers Conclave at the ongoing Def Expo in Lucknow. Then below you have India to work with Russia on copters. So India and Russia are going to work together because production localization of Ka-2260 light utility helicopters is in the process of being resolved. So India-Russia cooperation is expected here. So this was also on the sidelines of ongoing Defense Expo, Def Expo 2020 in Lucknow. And even India and UK have joined, have signed a pact on jet engines. So they're exploring options for collaboration on joint defense projects. And they're close to signing this pact of government-government agreement on jet engine technology development. Then this is center persists with toothless pharma codes. So despite several instances of breach of the voluntary uniform code of pharmaceutical marketing practices by pharma companies and demand from IMA, Indian Medical Association, and doctors to make it mandatory, still it is voluntary. Doctors, it is not mandatory, it is voluntary for the doctors. So this comes, this pharmaceutical, Department of Pharmaceutical comes under Ministry of Chemicals and Fertilizers. So it has yet again requested companies to abide by the code, uniform code of pharmaceutical marketing practices. It's not making it mandatory, it's making it voluntary. So this center persists with toothless pharmacope. And experts say compliance should be compulsory. Why voluntary? And this is Supreme Court bats for just compensation in accident cases. So Supreme Court has held that compensation payable to a road accident victim should not be as assessed, should not be assessed neither very conservatively nor too liberally, and it transforms into a bounty for the that it transforms into a bounty for the claimant. Just compensation should be given is what the Supreme Court says. On editorial page, the first editorial is on the front foot. So this is regarding RBI. The editorial talks of RBI's efforts to boost growth. It says this could change the sentiment in the economy. So you can see RBI in its endeavor to bring down financial costs in the economy has taken step. RBI, despite its finding its hands tied by rising inflation thanks to onion prices, found other means to drive down interest rates in the market. So you can see at the press conference after the announcement of Monetary Policy Committee's decision to not change the repo rate, Governor Shaktikant Das declared only half in jest that proceedings of the Monetary Policy Committee, which decided to hold rates, had already been discounted by the market. So this is there. It was said, don't discount the RBI, however, because he warned as such, because he says that, you can see, don't discount the RBI. He warned, pointing out that the central bank had at its disposal various other instruments. So RBI has unleashed several measures to boost the economy, to drive down bond yield as such. So it has taken steps in that direction. Exemptions to banks from providing for cash reserve ratio on fresh retail loans disbursed, you know, so that has been provided for. This helps banks shave off part of its costs, so that also helps the banks. Though repo rate did not change, but in a way money came in the hands of the bank. They have disposable money which they can lend out. Then second, also introduction of 1 and 3 year terms repo rates, you know, at policy rate of 5.15 for a total of 1 lakh crore is also another step RBI has taken. RBI has also fine-tuned its liquidity management process in a manner designed to help banks manage their interest costs better. And below you have for a data firewall. So this is regarding leak of medical information, which was in news. Maximum leak has taken from Maharashtra. So medical details like your CT scans, x-rays, etc. are in public domain. So this that editorial says speaks to have to, that there is an urgent need to have data protection law, which is still not passed in the country. And the lead article is listening to the call of the informal. So this talks about India's tiny entrepreneurs living in rural areas and urban fringes. So you know, they should not be ignored is what this article says. And this is about a second-hand clothes market in Kolkata. And this is complicating the tax regime further. So this article says that the new system of two tax domains and you decide which one you go for. So this system fails to offer any major relief to individual taxpayers. It removes incentives to save and invest, because if you don't save and invest and you don't take deductions, exemptions, then you have to pay lower interest rate. A lower tax rate. So this talks about this new tax regime. Then on your pet page on Fridays, you have this parley coverage in which a question is posed and new counter views are given. So this is regarding the budget. It says, does the budget do enough in providing a stimulus to growth? So the viewpoint which has come forth is that by not cutting spending despite constraints, the budget ensures momentum doesn't backslide. So constraints are there, but it's speaking of spending, which should boost the economy. So it spoke of national infrastructure pipeline and other initiatives. Then this is reducing custodial deaths. So this talks about how Indian police continue to torture suspects in custody, as they are rarely punished. Because police is rarely punished even for custodial deaths. On page 12, you have Supreme Court directive irks Rajya Sabha. So this is the law minister and Congress leaders, they disagree with the court view on powers of speakers. The court said that speakers should decide on disqualification of lawmakers on grounds of defection in within 3 months. On page 13, you have India to study air corridors with Central Asian countries. So this is External Affairs Minister S. Jayashankar. He says it's required to expedite the transport of goods. So, you know, so developing trade from via the Chabahar port in Iran is one way, but India would like to explore setting up air corridors with 5 Central Asian nations. That is Kazakhstan, Kyrgyzstan, Tajikistan, Turkmenistan. So these are Central Asian countries. So how trade can be developed with them? So this has been looked into. Then on international page, you have the continuation of the front page news regarding Trump acquitted from impeachment charges. And this is regarding coronavirus. And this is regarding Israel-Palestine conflict escalating after Trump's West Asia peace plan. These are continuation of old news. On business page, you have RBI opts for long-term repos, CRR exemption to lower rates. So as we saw in the editorial also, the front page says that repo rate has not changed, but then RBI has used other ways. Long-term repos and CRR exemptions, cash reserve ratio exemptions, have been used to lower rates by RBI. And this is RBI extends deadline for one-time debt recast for micro, small and medium enterprises. So defaulting commercial realty projects now get more time. And this is an interview with RBI Governor Shaktikant Das. He says about Operation Twist also, which aimed at rate transmission in the corporate bond market. And he says 1 lakh crore infusion will enable banks cut rates. On page 16, you have telecom operator Tata Teleservices said Department of Telecom has approved the merger of its consumer mobile business with Bharti Airtel. So this is also a merger in telecom sector now. And below you have Indian companies in China brace for uncertainty amid outbreak. So this is understood because of the new coronavirus outbreak in China. So now Indian firms based in China bracing for an uncertain month. So the new coronavirus outbreak has brought factories and services sector to a grinding halt. So here you can see factory workers, office staff are largely confined to hometowns. So that is it. These are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website, asr.com. Thank you.